President Yoweri Museveni spent yesterday, May 21st, in Entungamo District, where he had a guided tour of the Inspire Africa Coffee Factory project in Rashamaire Town Council. The construction works of the modern industrial coffee park in Rashamaire Town Council, which started in October 2023 at about 60% and expected to be completed in December. During the inspection, President Museveni said that he was pleased with the progress of the factory.
Because Africa has been bleeding for a long time. Has been bleeding because we get very low value for our products. And the bigger value is taken by foreign groups. The slogan here is United Coffee Chapter 1. That's what how these young people have termed the campaign. What they mean is that Africa will move together.
The president further promised to support the factory with the necessary materials for it to be completed on time.
We're going to do all sectors. That's why we're within Uganda, but also we think Uganda will act as an example to the rest of Africa.
Upon completion, the park will produce instant coffee, drip coffee, malt coffee, coffee energy drinks, and coffee beauty cosmetics. In the long term, the value chain will increase Uganda's coffee revenue from the current $1 billion to $4 billion. Today, May 22nd, the National Unity Platform President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu is expected in Kamuli District to resume his consultation meetings in Busoga. Kyagulanyi is expected to hold consultation meetings with some groups and later address his supporters at Kananage Primary School Playground in Kamuli. Party supporters in the sub-region have requested their party to address the fishing communities in Namasagali, Buyende and Namayingo, who accused the UPDF Fisheries Protection Unit of harassment. Despite police directives to halt nationwide consultative meetings, NUP's Deputy Secretary for Mobilization in Eastern Uganda, Andrew Karuya, noted that they informed the Territorial Police of Kamuli and that all stakeholders cleared them to hold the consultative meeting. However, the police spokesperson, Fred Enanga, stated in his weekly brief that these engagements are being held in contravention of the state laws. Yesterday, May 21st, after a restful stay in Nigeria in Nakasongola district, the pilgrims woke up early at 5 a.m. for mass, and by around 6 a.m. they resumed their trek. By the end of the day, they had reached Buganda region. Nebbi Catholic pilgrims have now gone through two sub-regions, West Nile and Bunyoro. Today, May 22nd, the pilgrims expected to stop for the night at Sasira in Nakasongola. They have so far covered over 200 kilometers since they started their trek from Nebbi district on May 15th.
It's about half the trip, yes, up the journey, the pilgrimage, yes. We thank God so far it's going on well. And the message is one from the beginning. Yeah, we are going, they're making the journey as pilgrims. It's a journey of faith and they're walking with the same spirit. The primary message we gave them was to look at the Uganda matters as their inspiration to keep them on the journey. And we have tried to sustain that spirit with the theme of the preparation of the celebration we have chosen as diocese, which says, "Me and my household, we shall serve the Lord." And that comes from the book of Joshua.
Devotion in prayer has been a constant trait for the pilgrims. Every time they get a chance to pray, they kneel and cry out to the Lord, seeking Him for the different reasons they are trekking to Namgongo.